producer, film score composer, and curator. Till Rorman, aka Glitterbug, is just as driven as he is versatile. He's released 3 albums to date, and his melancholic, atmospheric, deep techno-oriented sound is particularly well received abroad. It's not only in the head of the listener that he creates images. In his live performances, he in fact focuses on the merging of visuals and sound. Together with the impressive and mostly organic visuals of Israeli artist Roni Shender, the two give rise to an audiovisual work of art as a whole, whereby each art form is influenced by and dependent on the other.
Actually, it took me many years to call myself an artist, but I think that also has to do with some kind of family trauma. Both my parents are artists, and it was not necessarily always so easy to grow up in a very artist household. So it was actually something that I always wanted to shy away from in a way. So I chose music as my main direction. But I would say, yes, I would call myself an artist that works actually with the means of music. That would be my definition for myself. I come from a very diverse musical background in a sense of my own interests, and the music that I enjoy, and that like spans from both techno and pure electronic music all the way to very, very experimental music and contemporary composition and a lot of other things. So it took me a long, long time to actually develop my own musical language, and it doesn't matter if my music has bass drums or a certain track or piece has bass drums or not. I think that it's just different artistic vessels, and it doesn't really matter what the music looks like. I think that what matters the most is what's inside and what I try to transport, and if I succeed in trying to in transporting something with it, both emotionally and also content-wise. And I think that there's many different ways to express what you want to express. Challenging to put as much content as possible in techno, because everybody always claims that it's like the most empty musical vessel out there, and that it should be functional and that it shouldn't be like overloaded with too much stuff. I see it differently. I think that for me it's something that I think that like the club could be a much more utopian place than it is nowadays. And I also experienced, like looking at my musical background or also my socialization with club culture, I once upon a time experienced it much more as like a very liberating and as an utopian place. Process of making music and composing and producing is something that is very, very intuitive. It's not that I come to the studio in the morning with a great master plan and I say, okay, I work in this direction and this is the particular thing that I want to do. It's more, it's like a very intuitive process of building things. And one of the biggest challenges is to actually know when to let go and when to actually leave something as it is. And because I think every creative process is very, very much it's very influenced by your very specific mood and a very specific point in time. Try to find certain topics that are relevant for me in my life, in my surrounding, and try to bring it into my music and try to actually find content and context that actually has something to do with that I can speak about through my music. And doesn't matter if you look at like my first or my second or my current album, I think that's actually something that has been a very, very important part to create something that could be some sort of a journey of an expression of sorts, and which is something that is actually much more tells much more of a story than your, let's say, your average functional club music. But I still try to do it through the means of club music. Of mimicking what other people do, I can, of course, like my music is full of influences, and my music is full of things that I haven't invented. I mean, I haven't invented the straight bass drum, for example. some other people did before me, and I never claimed I did, but I think that it's very, very important to develop your own artistic language, and it's very important to try to create something that is true to yourself and to develop your own unique voice. And that is certainly something that after actually a lot of trials of trying to sound like other people or trying to produce something that could be relevant for this label or that label, I had something clicked in my head a couple years ago that actually whenever I try to do something that I don't really want to do, it's really bad. The outcome is really bad, and it's like really something that if I look at like a lot of stuff that I try to produce tailored for like a certain label to release it there, I realized rather quickly that it's just something that I'm totally incapable of. Life, it's a very emotional challenge also every time, and I'm like totally exhausted afterwards, but like I really try to put my heart and soul into it, and maybe that's the trippy part, because it's a very intense, very personal experience for me to play live, and I think it's something that usually the audience is also able to pick up on. And And actually, I think that like out of experience, it works even better with people that are totally sober than with people that are totally drugged out. most of the time, if I play live, I play with a visual artist named Ronnie Shandar, and she's, of course, a very, very important part of creating a certain mood and atmosphere in a club or a festival environment.
With the visuals that I do for Glitterbug, it's really important for me that on one hand the audience travels somewhere or is transported to some other dimension or a place or a concept or a context. On the other hand, to leave enough room for that place to still remain somehow imaginatory, to not say this is exactly what that place is, but to have people still participate in their own interpretation of it.
Shouldn't be functional. I think music should be an art form, and it shouldn't be about making the next big club hit, but it's about developing as an artist and taking the liberty of trying new things.